Hello, welcome to SS Unitech Social Decide, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about for each loop item enumerator. So let's start. So basically what for each item enumerator does. So it is used to enumerate through a list of items populated at design time. The list is static at execution time. So we can say that we cannot load list items dynamically from any configuration file or database tables. So here I have a case study where we want to create folders with the month name. So this is our folder path, and inside this folder I want to create 12 folders with the month name like Jan, Feb, March, April, May, June, like this. So go to on SSDT, and here I would like to add one more package. Then I wanna rename this package with for each loop item enumerator. I need to drag and drop this file each loop container, then double click on this for each loop container. Go to on collections. So inside this collection, as we can see, we are selected for each item enumerator. So here, as we can see, we have columns. So we just want to create one column, and we can click on add. So column 0 has been created, and data type should be a string. Now we can click on OK. So this is our column 0, and here we can specify the values, and this value will be used when our for each loop container will be executed. And we cannot pass the values on this column 0 by using any configuration file or SQL Server table. So here I just want to add Jan, and second is Feb, then March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, last is December. So I have created a column and put the values on these columns. So go to on variable mapping, and here I wish to add a variable. I wanna use name folder. Click on OK. Again OK. So what for each loop container does? It will pick these values one by one and put these values in our folder variable. So I can click on OK, and inside this I wish to use file system task. I haven't discussed about the file system task, and I'll discuss in our upcoming videos. Here I just want to create directory by using file system task. Inside this operation we have an option with create directory, and here if we want to pass folder path from our variable, then we can select yes, and here we can select our variable name. So before configuring file system task, let's create a variable, and this variable would be folder path, and data type should be string, and go to on expressions, and here I wish to copy this path, then we can specify this, and here I need to use our second variable, which is our folder, and it will get the values at the runtime from our listed items which we have write down in our for each loop container. So here we have to use double backslash instead of single, so we can use over here, then we can evaluate. I missed over here, so I can use, then we can evaluate, and we are getting. Now click on OK, and we can close this. Double click on this file system task, and here inside this operations we have an option for create directory, and we want to pick the folder name and path from a variable. So our variable name is folder path, so we can select, and here as we can see we have an option for use directories if exist, so we need to select with true. Now click on OK. As we can see, in this folder we don't have any folders right now. So once our package will be executed, then 12 folders will be created with the name of month. So I can click on start. So package executed successfully and folders are created in this directory. So I can stop this package. So I can stop this package. I hope you have understand. I hope you have understand how we can use for each loop item enumerator. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.